come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
From the Ray Stevens Studios in the heart of Nashville's Music Row in Music City, USA, it's Ray Stevens CabaRay Nashville.
My heart keeps going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My love is waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's guests, James Gregory, Helen Highwater String Band, and the A-Team. It's a camel. No, it's a squirrel. No, it's Ray Stevens.
Well, as I was driving down the road one day, I met a pickup truck coming the other way. He hit a big chuck hole and a pig fell out on the blacktop. Yeah, and that farmer didn't notice, kept cutting the jig. So I pulled over and I caught that pig, threw him in my car and did a U-turn right in front of a highway cop. Well, he flashed his lights and pulled me over to the side. By the time he'd finished reading him my rights, that farmer was long gone, didn't have his license or his name. So I asked the officer, what'll I do? He said, well, why don't you take that pig to the zoo? And I did. You know, we had so much fun, I'm gonna take him to a ball game. Kiss a pig, hug a swine. Some of them are good friends of mine. I'm specially prone to those Poland China porkers. More fun than a dog and smarter than a horse. And you might find them a little coarse, but shoot, they ain't near as rude as some New Yorker. Now that pig was a sight riding in my car, wearing a baseball cap, eating candy bars, and folks would ask his name, he'd say oink, and they'd just say howdy. Yeah, everybody knew he lived in my home, and that's how I guess he came to be known as Oink Stevens, ugliest man in Davidson County. Now here a while back things got real bad, you know, we almost lost everything we had, and old Oink lost a hound, had to build him a little peg leg. But as good as that pig had been to us, heck, we didn't have the heart to eat him all at once. You know, some things more important in life than sausage.
Kiss a pig, hug a swine. Some of them are good friends of mine.
I'm specially prone to those Yorkshires and Red Dew rockers. More fun than a dog and smarter than a horse. You might find them a little coarse, but they ain't near as strange as some of them punk rockers. Well, now here a while back, I'm sad to say, in the middle of the night, old Oink limped away. Must have overheard us talking about the coming recession. But he was my buddy, he was my friend, and he was my breakfast every now and then. And he never done me no wrong or gave me indigestion.
Kiss a pig, hug a swine. Some of them are good friends of mine.
I'm specially prone to those Hampshire porkers. More fun than a dog and smarter than a horse. You might find them a little coarse, but shoot, ain't near as rude as some New Yorker. Welcome to the show. Just come on in, get both feet in the trough, and enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. and in reality, I'm a secret agent.
Oh boy. Hey. Oh, 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 oh. Slow down, boy. Whoa, whoa.
What?
Here's a guy who played a lawyer in my latest movie, Get Serious. Name of the movie is Get Serious. And he talked the judge into throwing the book at me. He's one of the funniest guys I know. Ladies and gentlemen, James Gregory.
Hey, how you all doing? Now, remember that Ray said that I played a lawyer. I wasn't a lawyer, so I don't want you to get mad at me now. You know, lawyers can get in trouble. The only lawyers I get associated with is when I go and my cousin gets arrested and I go, you know what I'm talking about. We all got kin folks like that. I got crazy kin folks. Y'all have crazy kin folks? I mean, we love them, but, you know, I got one now. I had lunch with him 3 days ago. He's bragging, always bragging about something. He's bragging about a brand new 6-quart crock pot. And he don't have it yet because he's got it on layaway. And he tells me, he acts like it's the greatest thing in the world. He asked me, he said, do you have a crock pot? I said, no, I don't have a crock pot. You ought to get one. I said, I don't need one. He said, here's what you can do with a crock pot. You can put a raw chicken in a crock pot early in the morning, turn it on low, and when you come home from work that evening, it'll be ready to eat. Ain't that something? And I said, that's good, but you don't work. Like, you're home all day, you know. The reason he's home all the time is because he's never had a full-time job, because I don't think he knows how to fill out a job application. Where it says nearest relative, he'll put 12 miles. In case of emergency call, he write in like 911. Just crazy, crazy people. But it's good to be here. By the way, I got here about an hour ago, and I saw some of y'all outside. They had food here today, but outside the studio. It was wonderful, wonderful food. As you can tell, I love food. I tried every diet that don't work. A diet that I hated the most. A few years ago, they had this diet called the Stillman Water Diet. The Stillman Water Diet. You had to drink 18 glasses of water every 24 hours. I lost 2 pounds in one day. My bladder fell out. <You know? laughs> But I love good food. Have you noticed that young people today don't know how to eat real good? Young folks, they're getting politically correct on what they eat. I work and travel with other comedians. Some of these guys, bless their heart, these are weird guys. I mean, they're 25, 30 years old. We always stay at the same hotel. They'll call my hotel room and they'll go, we're going out running. You want to go? And I'm like, do what? We go run. You going? I'm like, no. But if you happen to cross a Krispy Kreme, you can bring me something back, you know. And I hate to go out to eat with them, especially, I love to go to the truck stops. And this is a true story that happened in Nashville just about, a year ago. They had me working with a 25-year-old comedian. We went to a truck stop, not a 4-star Mediterranean restaurant, this is a truck stop. We sat down, two comedians surrounded by truckers. Waitress comes over, big woman, not a lot of teeth. All this young guy wanted was a salad. Nothing wrong with that. But he asked this truck stop waitress, did she know whether or not any of those salad ingredients had ever been exposed to any type of pesticides? She said, well, we spray for roaches every now and then. I don't think none got on the legs. Now, hold on, this gets worse. She's talking to a man now. What kind of dressing you want? He said, raspberry vinaigrette. She looked at me. She said, you know what he's talking about? I said, no. A few minutes later, she put the food in front of him. He looked at it. I didn't know it come with cheese on it. I can't eat that. I'm lactose intolerant. She said, honey, that's not lactose cheese. That's cheddar cheese. You see, I wouldn't make fun of these guys if they would leave the rest of us alone. But the ones I just described to you that have the audacity to make fun of my food, they will point at my food and they'll go, do you know what that greasy food's going to do to you? I'm like, yeah, fill me up. I have to eat that way. I need to maintain my strength because I'm usually one of the pallbearers when my healthy friends drop dead working out. I love what they don't love. I love chicken fried steak, extra gravy, mashed potatoes, extra gravy. I was a grown man before I realized that gravy was not a beverage. Cornbread and a lot of butter. When I say butter, I eat real butter. You young folks, get yourself some real butter. Stay away from that phony stuff. You see it all the time. The heart healthy and smart balance and the popular one, I can't believe it's not butter, butter. Well, hell, I can. They'll say, I can't believe it's not butter, butter spray. Like, pss, pss. It's a butter mist. Pss, pss, pss. Trust me on this. If your daughter marries a guy who sprays his butter, there ain't gonna be no grandkids. I enjoy talking to you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
James Gregory, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, man. All right, Ray.
Well, James, you know,
it's good to see you.
It's good to see you. It's been a long time. You hadn't lost a thing, man.
Well, what? I tell you what, I'm a lot of my kin folks. I had an aunt, my favorite aunt, God rest her soul, you know, big woman. All my aunts were big, you know. And here's the way I just repeat what she used to say. As soon as I get home, I'm going to take a water pill. I think most of this is just fluid. You know?
Yeah, well, let me ask you. You look like you've lost weight now. Are you exercising more?
Oh, no. That exercise will kill you. Exercise will kill you. All I do, I just buy bigger shirts. It fools everybody.
I quit
going to doctors. You know, those doctors will kill you. You know.
Well, you know, I knew a doctor once. If you couldn't afford the operation, he could touch up the X-ray.
That's right. How about you? See, every time you go to the doctor, no matter what your problem is, they tell you to lose weight and they tell you to exercise. Well, I don't want to hear it. So I just don't go.
You're always traveling.
Yes,
are you still driving everywhere?
I drive everywhere I go. I'm afraid to fly. I've always been afraid to fly. I don't mind flying once a year just to catch up on my drinking and my praying. you can't smoke on an airplane either.
No, that's true. Yeah. You still smoke?
Yeah, I smoke my cigars.
Oh, cigars are not supposed to be as bad as cigarettes, I understand.
Well, I tell you, that's one reason that I don't join a health club. You can't smoke in a health club, you know, so. But now I don't like to fly. It's too dangerous out there, you know. But
you know,
hey, it's always been scary out there. Remember about 5 or 6 years ago when that U.S. Airways jet crashed into the Hudson River up in New York?
Yeah.
You remember what brought that plane down? Birds. Remember?
Sure.
Birds.
Yeah.
We're talking about an airplane, not a kite, not a balloon. This was an airplane knocked out of the sky by some birds, not a deer. Birds. And listen, this is an actual quote from Captain Sully. He was a hero, Captain Sully. Here's a quote. The moment I saw the birds coming, I knew there could be trouble.
Especially those duck-billed platypuses.
The last time a bird hit my car, who do you think went down? Case closed.
The bird went down.
You always look good.
Well, thank you.
I hate you because I know you eat good and you never gain weight.
Well, the thing, I eat anything I want, and for some reason, I don't gain weight. But
yeah, I hate people like you.
I'm just very lucky. You need to get some glasses, so I'll tell you that right now. One of the things about Nashville is the incredible diversity of talent that's here. Shad Cobb, Mike Compton, David Greer and Missy Raines are all great musicians in their own right. But when they decided to get together in a string band, something musically magical happened. And they call it Helen Highwater String Band.
I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. I'm lost, I'm lonesome, I got nothing left to lose. Lord, I'd give anything just to hear a bit of good news. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. I'm busted, I'm broke, I ain't got a dime. All I got is these four chords, these verses that rhyme. But I've been traveling around this world, I've been paying my dues. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. I'm lost, I'm lonesome, I got nothing left to lose. Lord, I'd give anything just to hear a bit of good news. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. I'll reach the other side. But I've been traveling around this world, I've been paying my dues. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. I'm lost, I'm lonesome, I got nothing left to lose. Lord, I'd give anything just to hear a bit of good news. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. Nothing left to lose. I've been traveling around this world, I've been paying my dues. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues. Lord, I'd give anything just to hear a bit of good news. I'm crying, I'm singing, I'm preaching these old blues.
Wow. Oh, that was great, guys.
Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart.
Now comes Professor Cusick. That's Cusick. Rhymes with music. When it comes to music, Professor Cusick is the one who's in the know.
The Encyclopedia of Recorded Comedy Music teaches us that this next song was a number 3 pop hit and career-making single for Bobby Darin. Bobby moved to Hollywood on the strength of this song, where he became a movie star and the most popular guest and host of numerous successful TV shows. It's just amazing what one hit record can do.
Splish Splash, I was taking a bath on a bike Saturday night. Rub-a-dub-dub, just relaxing in the tub, thinking everything was all right. Well, I stepped out the tub, put my feet on the floor. I wrapped a towel around me and I opened the door. And then, splish-splash, I jumped. jump back in the bed. Well, how was I to know there was a party going on? There were a splishing and a splashing, reeling with the feet, moving and a moving, rocking and a rolling. Oh, play that saxophone. Bing bang, I saw the whole gang dancing on my living room rug. Flip flop, they were doing the bop. All the teens had to dance and buzz. Well, there was Lollipop with a Peggy Sue. Good golly, Miss Molly, was there even that tune in? Splish splash, forgot about the bath. I went and put my dancing shoes on. I was a roping and a stolen, reeling with the feeling, moving and a grooving, splishing and a splashing. Ooh, yeah.
Splish, splash, 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 splash.
Well, I was a splishing and a splashing,
splishing and a splashing,
rolling and a strolling. Splish splash, yeah, I was a splishing and a splashing,
splishing and a splashing,
moving and a grooving,
moving and a grooving,
bopping and a hopping,
bopping and a hopping,
flipping and a flopping,
flipping and a flopping.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Now, my wife said she wanted the fur coat. She said you wanted the mink coat. So I went to the fur store, and boy, mink coats are really expensive. But they had one that looked a lot like a mink coat, and it was actually a hamster. And so I bought that one and took it home, and she loved it. And we went to the fair that night. Took me 3 hours to get her off the Ferris wheel. That's it for the show tonight. Thank you for tuning us in, and don't forget, we'll be back here next week at the same time, and we'll be looking for you. Now I need a dance partner. Wait a minute. I think I see one. There she is. Would you dance for me? Wait. Watch your step. I'm going to get you to hold it.
The program was recorded before a live audience in the Ray Stevens Studios in Nashville, Tennessee, Music City, USA. This is Bill Cody. We'll see you next time.
Come join us here at the CabaRay. That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.